Welcome to the session on the Global Tuberculosis Control Strategies. I am Dr. Paul Kumaran, working at the National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis. Before going into the global strategies, let's start with some of the definitions. Control of any disease is reduction of the disease incidence, prevalence, morbidity or mortality to a locally acceptable level as a result of deliberate efforts, whereas elimination is the reduction to zero of the incidence of a specified disease in a defined geographical area as a result of deliberate efforts. But the eradication of a disease is a permanent reduction to zero of the worldwide incidence of infection caused by a specific agent as a result of deliberate efforts. So, for control, we need continued intervention measures over a period of time, and also the same continued intervention measures are required for elimination purposes, but for eradication the intervention measures are no longer needed. The pre-elimination of tuberculosis is defined as less than 10 tuberculosis cases per million population per year, and the elimination of the TB disease is defined as less than 1 tuberculosis case per million per year. When we look into the evolution of tuberculosis control over a period of a century, initially the vertical approach for TB control was practiced. This is where the TB control program managers were dealing with the TB patients directly, resulting for tuberculosis control. This was successful in developed countries, but was a failure in many resource poor settings. So, the integration with the general health services was deemed essential for any TB control program, and because of the prolonged global neglect for TB control, WHO was forced to declare tuberculosis as a global public health emergency in 1993. Then came the DOT strategy, which was integrated with the general public health system, and in India the revised national TB control program implementation started since 1997. Later there was strengthening of the public sector integrated programs for drug susceptible and resistant tuberculosis with expanded partners came into the picture. The United Nations established the Millennium Development Goals in 2000 for 2015, in which the goal was to halt and reverse tuberculosis incidence. Following the Stop TB partnership in 2001 adopted the Millennium Development Goals, as by 2015 50% reduction in the prevalence of tuberculosis compared to the status in 1990, and a 50% reduction in the tuberculosis mortality compared to the scenario in 1990. Now, the WHO NTB strategy in 2014 for the year 2035 was with the goal of achieving end global TB epidemic. Subsequently, the United Nations also established the Sustainable Development Goals in 2015 for 2030 to end the global TB epidemic. Now, looking at the global TB control strategies, when we start in the early 90s, we had the DOT strategy, wherein we had the political and the governmental commitment for control of the disease. The key TB case detection was passive case finding, and we used standardized short course chemotherapy for treatment of TB patients. Regular drug supply was ensured for essential anti-tuberculosis treatment drugs, and supervision and evaluation were the focus during the DOT strategy. Moving on, from 2006 onwards, we started expanding to the Stop TB strategy, which had to pursue high quality DOTs expansion and enhancement. It had to address TB HIV, multi-drug resistant TB, and other challenges posed during the treatment of tuberculosis. It contributed to the health system strengthening, and it engaged all care providers. It empowered people with tuberculosis and communities, and enabled and promoted research for TB control. Now, beyond 2015, we are adopting the NTB strategy, which is an integrated patient-centered TB care and prevention program with bold policies and supportive systems in place, followed by intensified research and innovation so that we are able to control the global burden of TB disease. Looking at the evolution of tuberculosis control targets according to the epidemiological stage, the original DOT strategy focused on smear positive tuberculosis, and the chest symptomatics were tested and diagnosed. In the Stop TB strategy, we had enhanced case finding, including sputum smear negative tuberculosis patients, and in the NTB strategy, we have enhanced to active case finding mode for select high risk group population, emphasizing on the contact investigations, and we started treating or managing the latent tuberculosis infections also. This methodology is like scraping an iceberg from the top, so that we are able to create an epidemiological impact of TB control. When we are looking at the end tuberculosis strategy and the sustainable development goals, the vision for a world of zero deaths, disease, and suffering due to TB, approaching a 95% reduction in mortality, 90% reduction in incidence by 2035 compared to 2015. The milestones as 2020, 2025, 2030, and 2035 for a 5-year gap period for the reduction in number of TB deaths is from 35% to 95%. The reduction on TB incidence rate is from 20% to 90%, which will be for less than 85 per lakh population to less than 10 per lakh population. There should not be any TB affected families facing catastrophic costs due to tuberculosis. So, there are 4 principles with regard to the NTB strategy, which includes government stewardship and accountability with monitoring and evaluation of the program, building strong coalition with civil society organizations and communities for TB control, protection and promotion of human rights, ethics, and equity with adaptations of strategy and targets at country level with global collaboration. There are 3 pillars for the NTB strategies, which includes pillar 1 as integrated patient-centered TB care and prevention, the pillar 2 as bold policies and supportive systems supporting the TB control program, and the pillar 3 as intensified research and innovation needed for further control of TB disease. There are 10 components for the NTB strategy. Against the 3 pillars, for the integrated patient-centered care and prevention, we need to have early diagnosis and treatment in place. Universal drug susceptibility testing needs to be done. Systematic screening of contacts and high-risk groups needs to be done. Treatment of all with tuberculosis, including drug-resistant TB, and patient support. Collaborative HIV-TB activities, management of comorbidities along with tuberculosis, and initiation of preventive treatment of persons at high risk and vaccination against tuberculosis. When we look at the components for the bold policies and supportive systems, there should be a high level of political commitment with adequate resources for TB care and prevention. There should be engagement of communities, civil societies, public and private care providers in TB control program. And there should be an universal health coverage policy, regulatory framework for notification, vital registration, quality and rational use of medicines and infection control to be in place, with social protection, poverty alleviation actions on other determinants of TB. Intensified and research and innovation is needed for discovery, development, rapid uptake of new tools, interventions, strategies like new diagnostics, new drugs, and new vaccines for TB control, and research is needed to optimize implementation and impact to promote innovations in terms like innovative delivery methods for drugs. So, when we are to implement the NTB strategies, some of the implementation activities in terms of ABC like advocacy, baseline preparedness, and coordination and collaboration with other stakeholders are needed for effective TB control measures. With regard to advocacy, we need to advocate for and achieve high level of political commitment, high level of national mechanism to direct adaptation and implementation of the NTB strategy, and we need multi-sectoral collaborations. The baseline preparedness will be in terms of assessing the TB situation as to know your epidemic, status of response and health system capacity, and to assess the policy and regulatory environment. Based on the assessment, we need to be prepared for implementing the NTB strategy. Then we need to collaborate across relevant ministries and departments like health, finance, food and education. We need to collaborate with patients, affected communities, civil societies, private sector, and there should be national and international supporters and partners in advocating and implementing NTB strategy. Now, let us look at the global scenario of tuberculosis. Currently, the global TB incidence rate is around 100 per lakh population per year, and the declining trends is marked as a red line. We need to achieve the targets of the NTB strategy by following the blue line. With the current scenario, by optimizing the use of current and new tools emerging from the pipeline, pursue universal health coverage and social protection, still we will be not able to achieve the NTB targets. So, in order to achieve the NTB targets, we need to introduce new tools like the vaccine, new drugs and treatment regimens for treatment of active tuberculosis disease and latent TB infection with a point of care testing. So, the key messages for the global TB control strategies is that the NTB strategy opens new era of tuberculosis control. It concentrates on the latent TB infection management, targeting high and middle income countries and also the lower incidence countries. And the global achievements does not depend only on the complete regions, but it depends on the success of the implementation in the regions and in the individual countries. Let's all join hands to fight against tuberculosis. Thank you.